When I was your age, if somebody had showed me an iPhone and said, listen, this little small thing is gonna have all these amazing capabilities an iPhone has, and you're gonna be able to buy it, and almost everybody in America is gonna be able to buy it, affordable, and it's gonna happen in your lifetime, I would have thought they were crazy. I'd have said, yeah, maybe in 200 years, maybe 500, that's impossible. I don't know how Steve Jobs saw an iPhone. I don't know where that came from. I'll tell you this though, it was an out-of-the-box thinking that made that possible. And what made the modern iPhone possible is Steve Jobs got rewarded by the model, by the market. He got capital. He reinvested that capital so the iPhone kept getting better and better and better and better. That's how markets work. But you have to be free to do that. You have to have liberty to innovate, to think differently, to pursue truths that other people don't see. That's why free markets work. Communism and socialism is doomed to failure. It's doomed to failure because it destroys innovation and it destroys creativity. Make a list of all the big innovations that came out of the Soviet Union. It's a really short list. How about North Korea? How about Cuba? How about Venezuela? In some cases, maybe a zero list. Innovation and creativity is the source of all human progress. It's only possible in a free environment. It's only possible when people have the opportunity to pursue their truths, to explore different ideas, to innovate, to be creative. That's why liberty works. You don't have to understand anything about economics. You don't have to read economic theory. Understand man's fundamental nature as a thinking being that has the capacity to see things and do things differently, and a system that rewards that capacity and encourages that kind of innovative behavior leads to better human well-being. Thank you.